Hi everybody, my name is Christina Koch and I'm a NASA astronaut in the 21st class of astronauts. My class was selected in 2013 and we all graduated from our astronaut candidate training program in 2015. And now we all have great jobs contributing to the human spaceflight program while we wait for a mission assignment. Speaking of mission assignments, one of those might be on this rocket that you see here, the Space Launch System. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about it. Today, we are going to talk about the awesome new rocket that NASA is currently designing called the Space Launch System. Now, we don't want to have to say that every time, so we also call it SLS. And the SLS is new and different because instead of just launching astronauts to the International Space Station, which is in low Earth orbit, which is a couple hundred miles above the Earth, this rocket is going to take astronauts beyond low Earth orbit, back around the moon, and eventually onto Mars. This rocket is actually 322 feet tall. So the whole point of having such a big rocket with this much thrust is to get something to leave low Earth orbit. And this guy can launch 77 tons. The pointiest pointy end is actually what we call the launch abort system. It's a separate rocket in and of itself that will actually launch the astronauts that are up here at the top away from the rocket in the case of an emergency at the time of launch. All this rocket is all there to get enough propellant into the system and out the back to get this guy into space. Now, Orion is designed to carry 4 astronauts. And it's a capsule design, similar to the old Apollo capsules. So the astronauts, the 4 of them, sit, they're a pilot, a commander, and 2 other astronauts in Orion. And the idea is that Orion would be the only thing left after all this rocket is done doing its job, traveling into deep space. Okay, so now we're getting into the rocket components themselves. And this central part here is the liquid fueled portion of the rocket. Now the cool thing about this rocket is we're redesigning existing engines that were used as the space shuttle main engines, except now there's 4 of them on the bottom of this rocket, and they're all fed by a liquid fuel system that's liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen combusting to create thrust out of the bottom. The solid rocket boosters, or SRBs. These solid rocket boosters are revamped versions of the SRBs from the space shuttle. They're actually longer. They have other redesigned aviation and propulsion systems. The solid rocket boosters at the time of launch produce 8.8 million pounds of thrust. So how do all these components actually work together to make this thing go into space? Well, first of all, the SRBs are the heavy launchers, and they typically will jettison and be stopped early. So the SRBs are the first to go. Then the liquid-propelled RS-125s take over, and the liquid-propelled rocket is the next to go. Now, once we're actually in space, there's another stage that I haven't told you about yet. There's a stage on this rocket right here called the cryogenic propulsion stage. And it's the final rocket engine that gets this guy going once it's in space. It's also liquid fuel propelled. Thanks for joining me today. I'm Christina Koch, and this is my take on the SLS.